So all along with COVID, I've been saying that they've kind of been changing the rules just for COVID about a bunch of things. And one of them was about what constitutes a case of COVID. And in the past, it's always been, you know, have you got whatever the cause of the disease is, plus a bunch of other things, you know, what's your symptoms, you know, what's the situation you're in, all sorts of things go into whether or not you call it a case. Well, with COVID, that's one of the things they kind of redefined. You know, so if you take a test and it comes positive for SARS-CoV-2, they've been counting that as a case even if you're completely asymptomatic. And that's not what they've done. Anything else? Like if you test positive for HIV, you don't necessarily have AIDS, right? So that's kind of the same thing here. If you test positive for SARS-CoV-2, then you know you should only be counted as a case of COVID if you have some other stuff going on, some clinical symptoms, stuff like that. But that isn't what they've been doing. And I've been saying, okay, that's wrong. You shouldn't count any colonization of SARS-CoV-2. As a case of COVID. You know, it's only if you have the symptoms or whatever. And so I've been, you know, attacked from several different corners. And I think it was actually Potholer 54 and some of his users attacked me for that. For saying that even though that's how they've treated, you know, every other pandemic. No. It's different. Every you test positive and that's the case and that's what it is. Well, what has two thumbs and was right all along? This guy. Because the WHO released these guidelines for nucleic testing of polymerase chain reaction, PCR test, for SARS-CoV-2. And this, you'll notice, is to clarify information. So this isn't even something new they started doing. This is what they've supposed to have been doing all along. Now, they updated this on the 13th of January, but look when they released it. They released it on the 20th, the very day that Joe Biden became president. But I'm sure that's just a coincidence. But we'll get back to that. So, this is to clarify the information previously provided by WHO, supersedes, etc., etc. And that's okay. So, down at WHO guidance, diagnostic testing for SARS-CoV-2 states that careful interpretation of weak positive results is needed. The cycle threshold, CT, needed to detect the virus is inversely proportional to the patient's viral load. So, when you get tested for COVID, they just come back and tell you that it was detected or it wasn't. It's positive or negative. Your doctor gets more information than that. And one of the things your doctor gets is the CT, the cycle threshold. Basically, how much of the virus do you have? So obviously, when you first get the virus, it's going to be a tiny amount that you picked up from an infected person who touched something and then you touched it or whatever, and you get tiny amounts of the virus. Well, those viruses reproduce, and then those viruses reproduce, exponential growth. Pretty soon, you got it all over the place inside you. And so then you get whammed with it, and then as your immune system takes care of it, it drops off and drops back down. And as we've covered before, the way the test works is it's just looking for these RNA sequences. Well, the viral corpses, as we've discussed, they can stay around in your body for a couple of months, maybe even longer. And they're perfectly fine. Your body will process them out. They're dead. They're not doing anything. They're not causing any problems. They're just there. But the PCR test can pick them up. It'll just pick them up as a weak positive. So what does that mean? All right, well, let's consider a scenario. You, unbeknownst to you, get SARS-CoV-2, your immune system fights it off, but you're completely asymptomatic, so you're none the wiser. A couple of months later, you get a sinus infection. And the doctor says, well, you know, you got some of the symptoms. Let's check you for COVID. He checks you. The PCR test detects the viral corpses. And the doctor goes, oh my God, you've got COVID. Well, no, you don't. No, you don't. So, I mean, that's the thing about a weak positive. What do you want to set up a threshold above this? You've got, you know, the high viral loads that we need to worry about. And below this amount, you say, oh, well, you must have fought it off. Well, if you do that, then, you know, you're also discounting people who've just got the virus and it hasn't really had time to get away. So if you get a low viral load, it might be that you've already fought it off and you're better. It also might be that you just got it and you're about to get smacked in the face with COVID. And so there's no real way to tell from the test alone. So they say where test results do not correspond with the clinical presentation, that means the symptoms, a new specimen should be taken and retested using the same or different nanotechnology. Yep, you gotta look at the symptoms. You gotta look at a bunch of other things. WHO reminds IVD users, okay, this isn't anything new. This isn't new information. This isn't, you know, different guidance or anything like that. This is, you know, what it's been the whole time. Reminds IVD users, the disease prevalence alters the predictive value of test results. As disease prevalence decreases, the risk of false positive increases. So if the disease is less prevalent in your area, you know, then it's more likely that if you get a positive result, then it's not an actual case of COVID. So this means that the probability that a person who has a positive result, SARS-CoV-2 detected, is truly infected with SARS-CoV-2 decreases as prevalence decreases, irrespective of the claimed specificity. So we went over this with tests about specificity versus sensitivity. Specificity is your chances of getting a false positive. And the PCR test has a really high specificity. It's not going to really detect anything as being SARS-CoV-2 that isn't. And it has a pretty good sensitivity. In fact, some people say the sensitivity might be a little too good about it. You know, that's how much of a viral load. Like we were talking about earlier, if you've got a tiny viral load, what does it mean? Does it mean you fought it off? Does it mean you're about to get smacked in the face with it? Yeah. So, most PCR assays are indicated as an aid for diagnosis. It's not the end-all and be-all. Like a certain person has been trying to tell you all this time. It's an aid for diagnosis. Therefore, healthcare providers must consider any result in combination with timing of sampling, specimen type, assay specifics, clinical observations, symptoms, patient history, confirmed status of any contact, and epidemiological information, etc., etc. So, yep. Who was right? Who are you going to listen to next time? Amazing how often you end up being right when you actually follow the science instead of engaging in partisan political hackery and then insisting that everyone else follow the science when you're the one who didn't. What you going to do? What you going to do? What lessons are you going to learn from this? And of course, this comes out on the 20th. Now that we've got a new president, what does that mean? That means that everyone who's following these new guidelines will be counting results that they would have counted as COVID before. They're not going to count as COVID now. So things they would have counted as a COVID case back when Trump was president are going to not be counted as a case of COVID now, which means the numbers are going to go down, regardless of what the virus does. Because you're changing the way you count it. So keep this in mind, because before, you know, the news media has been all about, oh man, there's been, you know, so many new cases of COVID. Look at the new cases of COVID, the new cases. Oh my God, all these new cases. Well, what are they going to do now? Who wants to bet they're going to be saying, hey, look, there's not as many new cases. It must be because of Joe Biden. It must have been because of the clown that's in the White House and not the clown that previously inhabited the White House. Even though they're both clowns and basically had nothing to do with anything. Sorry, whoever is in the White House is not going to be able to control a virus. Virus gone a virus. President can't really do anything about it. He doesn't have magic powers. You know, Joe Biden is not, you know, a holy saint with healing powers. And Donald Trump, you know, isn't this, you know, evil demon or a Bond villain or anything like that, you know, spreading this, you know, biological warfare all over the world. Yeah, I don't know. And the other way, too, those of you who were regarding Trump as your savior and saying, oh, Biden's the big evil. No, they're both clowns. And neither one of them have the ability or the intelligence or the compassion or even just the basic, you know, ethical ability to run your life. None of them do. You run your life. You make the decision on how you're going to protect yourself and your family from COVID, and you discuss with your doctor how you're going to get tested and what actually is considered a case. And don't pay any attention to the crap in the news media. So, not that I'm saying that the WHO are a bunch of partisan hacks who did that on purpose, because I would never say that, because it might get this video kicked off of YouTube, but just saying, it's kind of funny it came out on the 20th, isn't it? Just something to think about. All right, comments for the common god, shares for the share throne. You know the routine. Like, subscribe, the bell. Go to donatedoublegosity.tv for all sorts of ways to donate, including PayPal and cryptocurrency. You can become a subscriber at Patreon and Subscribestar. They got to see this video early. They pretty much get to see everything early. No ads. And whatever you do, don't sweat what you're hearing in the news. Most of it doesn't really affect your life all that much. Consider, as you go through your day, how much you do that the government just isn't involved in. All the people that you interact with voluntarily and peacefully, you don't need government to do that. You know, all of the things you enjoy, all of the things that give your life meaning, they're all still there. There's still a lot of good and beautiful stuff in the world. And there's still a lot of good and beautiful people in the world. Politicians and the news media are trying to blind you all of that so they can pit us against each other. Don't let them do that. Never let them do that. Which is why I always like to end every video with the words, stay strong and be free.